Today is the National Day of Prayer. I cannot remember a time in my life where we needed to turn to God and seek Him in prayer more than now. In the middle of a worldwide pandemic, fear, uncertainty, mistrust, division, and anger are on the rise. No more than ever before do we need to have faith in God, to know that He is in charge and that the gospel of Jesus Christ is the only way to find peace and security in this life. Sometimes it's hard to know where to begin or how to pray. We just know we have a deep ache in our hearts that cries out for God's mercy and a longing to see Him move on our people. Today, I want to lead you in a time of prayer and worship. But before we begin, let us focus on whom we are praying, to whom we are seeking, the one true living God, the great I Am, to understand how great He is.
Oh Lord my God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee. How great Thou art, how great Thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee. How great Thou art, how great Thou art. When through the woods and forest glades I wander and hear the birds sing sweetly in the trees, when I look down from lofty mountain grandeur and hear the brook and feel the gentle breeze, then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee. How great Thou art, how great Thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee. How great Thou art, how great Thou art. That God, His Son not sparing, sent Him to die, I scarce can take it in. That on a cross, my burdens gladly bearing, He bled and died to take away my sin. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee. How great Thou art, how great Thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to Thee. How great Thou art, how great Thou art. Shall come with shout of acclamation and take me home. What joy shall fill my heart? Then I shall bow in humble adoration and there proclaim, my God, how great Thou art. Then sings my soul, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee. How great thou art, how great thou art, how great thou art.
Let us pray. Dear Heavenly Father, we come to you this day seeking only you, to praise you, to love you, and to bring our requests before you. Lord, we thank you for the great love that you have bestowed upon us. We thank you for the mercy that has changed our lives. We thank you for your grace that has saved us through your Son, Jesus Christ. Lord, you have given us so much that it doesn't even seem right to ask you for more. But you have told us to bring our fears, our needs, our requests before you. So today, Lord, we want to pray on behalf of our nation and our people. Lord, we pray for our leaders, federal, state, and local. Lord, we ask you to be with each one of them, to give them wisdom, to give them courage and integrity, to bring them together, to heal the lines of division and politics, to have them always remember that they serve on behalf of the American people. Lord, put it on their hearts, the oath they swore to defend the Constitution of the United States, and for them to keep the government of the people, by the people, and for the people. Lord, we pray for our doctors, nurses, and all those who are working on the medical front lines. We pray that you give them strength to endure the long and stressful hours. We pray for wisdom in treating those who are sick. We ask you to protect them as they seek to help those in need. Lord, bless their work. Bring healing through their hands as only you can. Lord, we pray for our law enforcement officers, our firefighters, and our military. These are the ones who put themselves in harm's way to protect others. We ask for their protection and strength as they serve in each different uniform they wear. Help them to accomplish their missions, to save those in need, to protect those who cannot protect themselves. As they provide the security of our nation, not only on foreign fields, but on the city streets and in the homes that are in need. Lord, we just pray that you continue to help them to do their jobs, protect them and their families. Lord, we pray for those in our nation battling with sickness and disease. We ask for your healing of their bodies and the restoring of their souls. We ask that they will understand, that we will all understand, that life is fragile, that you are the only one we can put our trust in, for you are the only one that is faithful and true. And in you there is healing, not just of the body, but of the soul, of the mind, and of the heart. Lord, give those who are dealing with sickness and disease faith in you to look to the one who can truly heal them and save them. Lord, we pray for those who have lost loved ones from sickness and disease. We ask you to comfort them, to comfort their families, and that in this time of sorrow and loss, that they will look to you to find the answers to why suffering and pain exists. That they will find the truth of your healing presence and your grace that restores the soul. Lord, that they'll understand that death is not final and that life eternal can be found in you.
Lord, we pray for those who have lost their jobs in this crisis. We pray that our economy can recover quickly and that jobs will soon be available. We pray that their needs during this time of unemployment will be met, that people will look to you for their security, that you will give them hope in your provision. Lord, we pray for the business owners who are struggling, that they'll be able to recover quickly from this loss of business, and that they will all be able to provide for their families. Lord, our nation is hurting in so many ways right now. But if we will humble ourselves, if we will repent from our sinful ways, if we seek you on our knees, you will hear us. You will heal us. Lord, we lift up our nation to you and ask for mercy. We have strayed from you in many ways, more ways than can be counted. But where sin abounds, grace abounds more. I pray this, that our nation will turn to you, that our people will turn to you. They will repent and they'll look to the true living God, the one who created them, the one who has given them life, and the one who loves them more than many of them know or understand. But that during these dark days and these hard times, Lord, that you will help us. You'll help all of them to know how much you love them and that they can come to you. And in you, we will find our hope. We'll find our peace. And we will find our strength to deal with the days that we live. We pray this in your name. Amen.
When the solid ground is falling out from underneath my feet, between the black skies and my red eyes, I can barely see. And when I'm feeling like I've been let down by my friends and my family, I can hear the rain reminding me. In the eye of the storm, you remain in control. In the middle of the war, you guard my soul. You alone are the anchor. When my sails are torn, your love surrounds me. In the eye of the storm. When my hopes and dreams are far from me and I'm running out of faith, I see the future I picture slowly fade away. And when the tears of pain and heartache are pouring down my face, I find my peace in Jesus' name. In the eye of the storm, you remain in control.
Yes, you do, Lord.
In the middle of the war, you guard my soul. You alone are the anchor. When my sails are torn, your love surrounds.
And I just don't know how I'm gonna make ends meet. I did my best, now I'm scared to death that we might lose everything. And when a sickness takes my child away and there's nothing I can do, my only hope is to trust you. I trust you, Lord.
In the eye of the storm,
you alone are the anchor. When my sails are torn, your love surrounds me.
control. In the middle of the war, you guard my soul. You alone are the anchor. When my sails are torn, your love surrounds me. In the eye of the storm.
Dear Father, Creator of the heavens and earth and all who inhabit your creation, the one who sent his Son to die on the cross for the sins of the world so that we could be born into the kingdom of God and live eternally with you forever, I lift up the church, believers united under the banner of love and forgiveness through the blood of Jesus Christ, and ask that you would glorify yourself within our body. Teach us to obey your word. Where we have erred, show us truth. Like a good shepherd, train us to walk with you. Replace our fear with knowledge of your power and glory. Give us hearts that seek after you. I pray that our pastors and ministry leaders throughout this country would seek you above all else. Help them to discern the times and lead your people with wisdom and truth. Protect them from evil. Deliver them from the temptation to lose focus on what Christ's example was, which was to seek and save the lost and minister to the sheep. Strengthen them with your spirit. May they do your will in spite of discouragement and opposition that is sure to come their way. Give them the resolve to preach during this unprecedented season the truth of Scripture with power and conviction. And may their commitment to love the church as Christ loves the church keep them at their post in spite of the waves that will come. May our church members grow in grace and the discernment of truth. What is truth? Your word is truth. Your Son is truth. I pray that each family and individual within the body of Christ would put their armor on, that the knowledge of salvation through Jesus Christ would be firmly planted within their minds, thoughts, and hearts. I pray that they would walk in the righteousness that is to be had through Jesus who imparted his righteousness within them. Surely, this is a time when truth is being quieted, and may the truth of Jesus reign in the testimony of your people. During this time of distress, may peace rule the day as they stay focused on the one who gave us peace through his own death. And give them the boldness and security in your power and authority to proclaim that peace to their families, friends, and neighbors who are in need of this peace of the gospel. Give your people a passion for your word, and may your spirit show us how to use your word to comfort, to love, to forgive, to walk the way that Jesus walked. To align our will with the heart of your word. When those fiery darts of frustration, anger, division, fear, anxiety, and hopelessness threaten to overtake them, may they remain standing in faith in the one who conquered death and sin, Jesus Christ. Give us boldness to share with a hurting world the good news that you have sent your Son to rescue us. We pray that the gospel would fall like seed on the ground and take root in good soil, bringing many repenting sons and daughters to the cross where mercy reigns and love pours forth for all who believe. I pray this in the name of the author and finisher of our faith, Jesus Christ. Amen.
Holy, 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 Lord God Almighty, early.
Dear Heavenly Father, you love us more than we will ever know. And Lord, we ask you that your love will fill our hearts, that the love of Christ will penetrate these dark days that we live, these days of uncertainty, these days that we see division amongst us. We see anger and hatred on the rise. Lord, that your perfect love will cast out all fear, heal all division. Lord, the enemy fights hardest when he knows we're making a difference in your name. Satan wants fear. He wants division. He wants anger and hatred. But you, God, are bigger than Satan. Your word tells us not to be anxious about anything, but in every situation, by prayer and petition, with thanksgiving, present our request to you, and that your peace will transcend all understanding. It will guard our hearts and our minds in Christ Jesus. Dear Heavenly Father, we praise you for your truth and for your love. We're grateful that you have set us free from sin and from death. We ask that your name be proclaimed, that all plans to silence the name of Jesus would be thwarted and crushed. We pray that many would come to know you as Lord and Savior. We pray that many would see your light, their blind eyes would be open, and they'd be released from the darkness that imprisons them. We pray that you would unify us, your people, for the glory of your name, that all who call themselves believers in Jesus Christ, who call themselves Christians, disciples, would rise up strong together. Lord, wake us up. Remind us to be aware of the days we live, to redeem the time, to listen to your words, and be willing to step out and serve in your cause, not our own, but yours, for you to use us to make a difference. Lord, we need you now more than ever before as a nation. Our time, our days are all in your hands. And we're thankful that those hands are full of grace. We're thankful that you are forgiving and merciful. We thank you that you are strong and mighty, and to you we can completely trust. Thank you that you are not against us, but you are for us, and that you still fight for us to this very day. Lord, we ask you to bring glory to your name, for you alone are worthy. Help us, Lord, to keep you as our vision, to keep our eyes focused on you, and that our vision in the days ahead will be visions of the one true living God, the great I am. We pray this in your name. Amen.
not be all else to